5 in the national canvas, obviously it does reflect that the youth or the Malaysians, the younger ones now, is expecting how the Navy would be in 2015. So it shows that we are on track, and at the same time, I think we have a bit to achieve by it from the youth target group. So we are doing this to transform the Navy. We believe that we in the Navy exist because of the fleet. And that was how it was initially started. We have gone through many processes before at the Malaysian Armed Forces level, at the government level, in trying to do something and justifying just based on geopolitical, geostrategic argument. But being a peaceful country is very, very difficult because they always compare how much does a submarine cost, how many hospitals and schools can they be built, how many roads can, how long the roads can be built because of just we equate it for one ship or submarine. And we justify that we need such change to achieve national dividends. That means we actually contribute to the nation, driving the ecosystem, changing the ecosystem, which I think all of you are stakeholders to the ecosystem. We actually can contribute on the social dividends, meaning create more jobs, opportunities. So all those together, we coined this term called national dividends. 15 classes and involving 7 nations. For some countries, I think after 20 years, you phase out the vessel. But I think for Malaysia, because we can't get the right funding, we need to sustain them. In the Navy so far, they have now 3 vessels already past 15 years. But what does it mean here? You know, that we need to actually spend more in order for us to sustain those capabilities. And this is not cheap. Now, that is what we have shown the government. If we continue to maintain the fleet early on, which I've shown you, the cost to us to maintain those fleets, this is a trend. And this is something that conscience of the Chief of Navy, that I've told PM, the Prime Minister, that sir, if this is what it is, and we will continue to spend good money and into this process. And still, we are not able to get the right outcome. A classic example is Hang Tuah, which I'd like to share with all of you, since he's going to be a museum piece anyway. You know, having spent every year, you know, millions of ringgit, we can only have her up there 65 days out of 365 days. And that's not good in terms of having spent money, but she's not able to perform. So for those ships, we have to face, we already faced it out. And because facing it out, actually now, we have now started to save it. So if we're able to save 1 year 50 million ringgit, for example, maybe the government should also add another 50 million ringgit to us as a reward. But he was looking at me in a different way. I said, before he said, open his mouth, he said, sir, beggars cannot be choosy. So maybe 10% of that would be fine as well. So he took it with a smile. So why we transform? Because why can't we change? Why can't we get new ships? Because whenever we ask for a certain amount, we only get about half of what we ask. So there's no way that we're able to get the ships, new ship built based on the usual way of doing things through the development of Malaysia. Now, these are the challenges being faced by Malaysia and many other countries. One obviously is a physical challenge. But now I think we are getting a lot better. I think in all fairness, the nation has been doing very well in terms of actually its economic performance. It's now going down to 60 plus. Yeah. So that was what it was actually talking about, fiscal challenges that drive us to do things in a different way. The other thing is what involves all of you here is, can we create something which is sustainable? But to me, it's better for me to share with you the outlook, where we are going, so that we're able to be be able to prepare yourself better, position yourself better, maybe consolidate in looking into continuing to support the Royal Malaysian Navy. At the same time, fiscal challenges facing the nation, it will be a continuous challenge for all of us. And this is a big challenge, a huge challenge, and is a real challenge. Unfortunately, over the years, we have been doing things based on maybe not so much on real requirement, but on sometimes perceived requirement, and maybe driven by forces which is outside our control, the Royal Malaysian Navy. So this is one of the huge challenges that we face and we realize. And by adopting a slightly different approach, we're able to now insulate ourselves through reducing the classes to 5. Looking at this change from 15 to 5, all right, we're able to again create more savings from the phasing out. At the same time, optimize budget to improve the asset management and procurement processes, and hopefully also contribute, so I will put that in yellow, to the defense industry, especially the shipbuilding industry. Business can no longer be as usual, and I hope that this is what we are telling ourselves in the Navy. But I think here, we also, like you all, to also think in a similar way. You need to actually be working on really own capability. You need to actually build yourself the sense that you are able to sustain, even not getting government contracts. I know they're very difficult, but this is the reality of life. So as far as we are concerned, we are now on track. We are not turning backwards. So as a young lieutenant commander, when I went to conferences, exhibition, I go and collect all these nice brochures. I would like the Navy to have the best system in the world. And we lay down the brochure and say, okay, the system that we want to have must meet this requirement, must meet this capability and everything else. And I think in reality, to deliver that such a system, it's going to be very, very expensive. The first thing is that we can't afford the best thing in the world. And I don't think so. We need the best thing in the world. And it's being driven by true needs and not perceived needs. At the same time, understanding the fit for purpose and also being practical about the whole thing. We are also now hoping to drive more in the aspect of optimizing local content, local capability, with the view of reducing costs and reducing risk. There may be some things that are already available by focusing off the shelf rather than really wanting something very special requirement sets. And we realize that by doing this, we are now bringing down costs of our ships that we will be planning by about 50%. Very important new concept we have adopted, not just in case, we are not driving just in time. Passing the risk to the vendor, to the supplier, and bringing the cost of doing business down. And nowadays you can still be able to get the equipment in time. This is how we able to justify to the Prime Minister and also the National Economic Council. The first time when we present 15 to 5 to the National Economic Council, the concept was approved. That was way back in May last year. And last week, we presented again to the National Economic Council. On the 12th of March, we have presented the how we want to finance it, and the first phase of the transformation program, which is for 10 years, is now being approved by the National Economic Council, which involves building of 6 petrol vessels, 14 littoral mission ships, 2 multi-role support ships, and 18 fast interceptor craft. Okay. If we were to continue business as usual, we will be losing, just for easy to calculate, just looking at the loss of revenue to the nation to illegal fishing or poaching is about 6 billion ringgit a year, because we don't have enough ships. And so does the our friend from the APMM or MMA. The loss of revenue from illicit trade, smuggling through the sea, about 4 billion. So you just combine those two, not taking into account the rest, it's already 10 billion a year loss of revenue per year. No, so when we say to the Economic Council, by having the 15 to 5, the Navy alone, not taking into consideration, let's say MMBA, we can guarantee of a 10% reduction of the loss. So the 15 to 5 is actually, the other way to put it, is actually a national investment. By investing in the 15 to 5, the government, right, we're able to get the return, which is the reduction of loss of revenue by 10% per year. Everybody is just looking into from the perspective of what's in for us. And I think that needs to change. I think what you need to do is what are you able to contribute back? How are you able to contribute to the nation? So by having these two change of thought processes, I think we should be able to be on the right track. So as far as industry is concerned, by 15 to 5, we're able to change the trend, or call from the boom and bust attack of a shipbuilding industry. Whenever they get any contract and everybody, all the resources goes up, you know, everybody was happy, and after that, no contract. So they were very busy for maybe 3 to 5 years, then very quiet for another 5 to 10 years. It is very important for us, the Navy, continuously engage our stakeholders. And I think this is why I would like to thank the industry division that given the Navy an opportunity to share with you so that you're able to understand why we are doing this. And we are talking to even our Navy people that not just industry need to change, the mindset of within the Navy ourselves, we need to change to prepare for the transmission program. One of the strategic partners that actually bring and really, which really helped us to achieve more savings, whether you believe or not, is the SPRM or the MACC. Bringing them on board brings very, very interesting dynamics to the whole procurement processes. It drives us to approach things in a much more transparent way. I think if you look at that from the concept-wise, I think that is the way to go forward. So SPRM or MACC really helped us to save a lot. And just to show that these are the processes that we need, we have gone through, that went through when we engaged the Economic Council, those are the members, PM Center then. We've given directives to go through many processes. Very, very rigid and professionally done, and through a what we call independent validation and verification process by professionals. These are some of the things that we have done to achieve efficiency savings in 2017. So we actually achieved at the end of the year, last year, 31st December, we closed the account, we actually achieved 98 million ringgit instead of what was forecasted, which was a conservative figure of 62 million. Smart contracting now is, we used to have two hydrographic vessels, very, very expensive to maintain, few hundred people to mend those two ships. So by changing the whole dynamics, we just said that now we're not working about system, we do not want to worry about the specification of the equipment. What we want is now, we want this data or this quality, and those data or quality now must be achieved within this time frame. And we just need 6 people instead of 300 people to do this job. So just 6 people, our hydrographers goes on board this vessel now, which we lease, doing the job, and based on performance based contracting. We drive the contract down from 90 million ringgit for 3 years to a 36 million ringgit for 3 years. So we save 2/3 of the price just by changing the concept. And now we are getting all the data and much more faster than what we used to do before with 2 ships and 300 people. I mentioned about process improvement. There are a lot of things that we have done. So now we are centralizing a lot of contracts, and I think that dragged the cost down hugely, I think about 40%. For 2018, we are looking at more initiatives. One of them we are very excited about, which is now in the process now, of our merit quarters. We've got 39 blocks of a high-rise building in Lumut, each comprising of 110 units, 10-story high. It has been now 35 years, those blocks. And there were 300 companies, contractors registered to do the work to repair those 39 blocks. 300 companies. But actually we realized that only 4 companies actually does the job. And we have engaged all the 300 companies. We told them that this has to change. So just a simple example. So you spend so much, but yet the satisfaction level of the occupants is very low. So by adopting this new concept, which is hopefully to be kicked off this year, we now drive on a performance base. You maybe have a small van that's roaming around the base, which will have a maintenance kind of a van. 80% of the space required to do 80% of the job, he will have space for to do 80% of the jobs in his van. Then we're applying a mobile app. Very quickly, the housewife can take a picture, send a number, and within half an hour, someone will call her, "Are you at home this afternoon?" "Yeah." "Will you come by and do the work?" And it will be done maybe within half an hour to 3 hours. What was before, maybe 3 weeks job, to sometime 3 months job. So what we are saying is that you need to find new ways of doing it. We need to look into new initiatives and that not only provide better performance, not only achieve higher satisfaction level of the user, but more importantly, saves and also hopefully drive the change in the ecosystem, which you are all part of the stakeholders. So aspiration for the 15 to 5, I hope that this, as much as we need to actually take this all into account, in terms of our, to meet our aspirations. I'm hoping that we do have this close and strategic collaboration between industry, between stakeholders, with the Navy and the budget industry, obviously. Local industry, I think you need to do more. As I mentioned just now, do not rely on government for business. You need to really build your own capability. And government can help up to a certain extent, but after that, you need to actually survive on your own in the real world out there. I have to say this in the sense that I'm proud that some of you have really achieved our expectation. And we are collaborating with those companies that are really up to the level where they are willing to take risks, they are willing to invest, and not just hoping to get special favors from the Navy or from the government. And please, whatever that you do, please think of how can you contribute back to the nation.